Hi there. Today for blade testing, we're going to be looking at some stone sharpened Scandi edges. So this data from this can't really be put too close in with the other stuff, because the other stuff's all micro-convex work-sharp edges. However, it's a good indication still of how the steel performs. First of all, I'm going to go with the traditional Mora stainless, which is 12C27, versus Mora's carbon steel, which some say is 1085, others say is 1095. Both of these are super sharp right now. I've stone sharpened them and put quite a mirror polish on them. They are probably about as sharp as you can really get these knives, I would say. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut rope with them still, same rope, because it is quite uniform, and see how many each one can do. Stand by. Well, there you go. You see why I don't categorize these in the same as the pocket knife or the standard bevel or convex bevel cut tests. The Scandi edge, it gets really, really good results for a long, long time. However, it's a lot different of an edge to the sort of more everyday carry convex edge that you can probably put a bit more stress under. So what you've got here is an absolute zero ground Scandi blade, which has a really, really sharp, fine tip, which lasted quite a long time because I was doing standard straight up and down cuts. Has its positives and it has its negatives. Its positives are that it does stay sharp for a lot longer than my work sharp edge, which is a sharp edge, but this was something else. Like, this is completely, I mean, these are still razor sharp down this end, and they're just like, you split hair with that, it's so sharp. Like, the edges I've been getting on my pocket knives and the other knives you've seen in the previous tests, they're all sharp and they'll shave, but they are not as completely fine as these. So anyway, so these fine edges lasted a lot longer than your standard 20 degree inclusive convex that the workshop's been putting on the pocket knives. So we'll get that out of the way straight away. So Scandi seems to hold its edge a lot longer in the rope cutting test. However, really interestingly, it goes dull really suddenly. So up here, not sharp at all, really, really quickly. Down here, I wouldn't want to do that. So I use this part and up obviously in the test. Anyway, so that aside, so that's just, it's dull straight away. So what it is the Scandi, once it's lost its really fine edge, it kind of rounds off really quickly. So this one, 88 passes, pretty good. Like, considering this is quite a thin knife, you could put this kind of blade on a pocket knife, and people do. However, this one, 133 on what could be 1085 or 1095 steel. If you know, please let me know in the comments, and please link to it so it's not just conjecture, because I can't really find a 100% credible source at any rate. So yeah, 88 passes, 133 passes, both held for much longer, but then went dull almost instantly, whereas the other knives all had really good working edges still, whereas this kind of has just gone straight to needs a complete rework. So swings and roundabouts, I guess. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this little test. It does go to show that the carbon may well be a better buy if you're paying the same price for these, as long as you're happy to take care of your knife pretty well. And, you know, these would stay sharp against wood for a long, long time, because as I often say, wood is nowhere near as rough on knives as stuff like this. This is fibrous and, you know, quite rough and abrasive. Every single little strand of this is like a little plier, whereas wood, you, especially if you're cutting with the grain and whatnot, do that for a lot longer, I would suspect. But there you go, this is the only way I've got really, this is the only most uniform material I've got to do these cut tests with, so there you are. Anyway, good data point. Next up, we're going to do a sole video on A2 steel from the LT Wright heat treat and Genesis knife. Cheers, see ya.